All right.
Good afternoon. I can't even say afternoon, it's just noon. How's it going, folks? See that, Freddie? That's fun to work with, huh?
Yeah, it's like real life Play-Doh.
Freddie, you want to say hi to everybody?
Freddie, say what's up. Why?
What's up?
There you go. Gus, Chef Gus is getting back in it. Gus, what'd you do today? Did you do some reading on your new school computer?
20 minutes of reading.
I was supposed to do 30, but the pages were like a lot.
Really?
I started a big chapter book.
What was it about?
Magic people.
Sure. Awesome. So, how's it going, guys? We are doing Easter brunch, lunch, a day early so that you guys can make it this tomorrow and celebrate with your family. Just a reminder, last night we did the olive oil cake. It came out great. I let it sit, and I think that if you make it today and you actually wrap it up and let it sit overnight, it's going to be more moist and delicious for brunch tomorrow. And then we did the steak with the potatoes and the hollandaise with the béarnaise sauce. Great dishes as well.
And we also had chicken nuggets for dinner.
And we had chicken nuggets for dinner last night, and we watched Groundhog Day, and we're living Groundhog Day, essentially. So that was pretty good. So today we're going to make crepes. And we're going to stuff them with a little bit of a mustard mixture, ham, cheese, and then we're going to make a bechamel or a white sauce, and we're going to turn it into a mornay, which is actually that white sauce with the addition of cheese. Great thing to have in your repertoire when it comes to like making, like if you want to make like a white lasagna, if you want to make nacho cheese, you can kind of use a similar technique and add more cheese, but a great thing to have in your repertoire. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and get ourselves set up. I'm going to make crepe batter here. And I like to have a blender. I took this from work. This is a Vitamix blender. It's a great blender, but if you just have like one of your home blenders, it's totally going to work. So I have 1 cup of warmed milk. This is a great thing you can do a day ahead of time as well. You know, we're always looking for those things that we can do a day ahead of time to make the recipe a little bit easier. So if you can actually do quite a bit of the components of this dish a day ahead of time. And then I'm going to melt this butter here.
Can I melt butter?
I'm going to add 2 farm fresh eggs. I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder.
Gus, what did you think about the movie Groundhog's Day? Like Dad wants to know.
It was fun.
Can I have the egg?
It was good?
Here, put that
you
in
punched
there.
The annoying guy in the face with his phone. What? So like crack it?
Crack it and put it in here.
Use the stool if you need.
Here. Look, see that's membrane right here? Yeah, poke that, then you can open it up. But, you know, it's going to be okay. Just a little bit of sugar. And so, the milk is slightly warmed. We've got the eggs, baking powder, just a sprinkle of salt. We're going to get that nice and mixed up. I'm going to add 3/4 cup of flour.
Can I do something?
Yeah, of course. And then we're going to turn this on. You don't want to, once the flour's in there, you don't want to go too crazy with it, but you do want it to be nice and smooth.
It looks like we're making a smoothie.
And then crepes are sometimes called French pancakes. Okay, hey, this is hot. Here, grab this. Dump it in here. So I put make sure that the butter's hot, and that's the reason that we warm up the milk, is because you don't want to put warm butter in cold milk, or else you'll get clumps. The same thing we'll go over when we make the duck stack pancakes. So this is crepe batter. So
crepe batter.
Nice and crepe. Smooth.
Crepe. Are we gonna like
watch out, stand back.
Are we gonna like freeze it?
So nice, and then what I like to do is just refrigerate it for a half an hour or so, maybe even an hour overnight. All of those times are fine. Now let's talk about.
You can be in the fridge for as long as you want.
Let's talk about making the crepes, guys.
What is a crepe?
What is a crepe?
I thought it was a grape.
What is a crepe, you ask?
Yeah, what's a grape?
So.
Where do you want me?
We're gonna,
right over here?
Yeah, we're gonna make a bunch of crepes here. A lot of stovetop stuff here today. Chef Freddy, what you got going on? You can use butter for this project. I find it to be a little bit easier to use just a nice high quality Kroger brand coconut oil spray or a canola spray. And I'm gonna do two at once. Because we only have so much time. Yeah, so when I tell you.
Holy sh.
I'll take it off of you, don't worry. We're cooking! You still want to spray it? Good. Okay,
that
so.
That was so fun. I was so close to it.
What we're going to do is you can do one at a time. You want crepes you want to do really fast over a fairly high heat. And I'm doing two at a time because it's what I do for a living. And we only have so much time to make these crepes. One of the kind of rules of thumbs that happen a lot is the first one doesn't work out. And so I'm pouring a fairly thin layer. You don't want it to be too thick, and you want to swirl it around real nice. And you can get into a rhythm. This pan's not quite as hot, so it's not grabbing. But if you've had crepes, or if you have like a 1 ounce ladle, that's really great. Most of the cooking gets done on one side.
That's pretty cool. It already looks like it's
turning. So what you can do is if you have this kind of similar to the omelet, spatula tools. You can just get under there, flip it over. It's got some egg in it for sure.
Like pancakes? So we're making pancakes?
We are kind of making, get this in your hand.
Go in that bottom drawer there, Gus, and there's a little ladle in Freddy's cooking bin.
This?
So then I'm gonna knock this out onto my cutting board. I'm gonna have my trusty helper spray the pan out. And then we're gonna.
A ladle is a spoon, Gus. Like a scoop spoon.
So this one happened faster because the pan was hot. And then there's the.
One of these?
Yeah.
What do we need it for?
And so what you'll do is you'll get into a rhythm, and at the restaurants, when you're doing them, we can do, you know, six at a time. One time I did 1,000 of these in a row, all nonstop, and I was just turning like this nonstop. It was when we were doing the James Beard Awards dinner in New York, and I actually gave myself vertigo from spinning in a circle for like 4 hours of dizzy.
Do I get to
spin? So you see how we create, once you do it, once you get it down, you kind of get into a nice rhythm where this one's coming off. And you see how I'm just shingling them and I'm not stabbing them too tough so they don't stick. So I'm spraying.
They're going to taste like coconut.
Technique for the one-handed flip.
So the one-handed flip. Do not try this at home unless you're stuck at home.
You might want to turn the vent on. I feel like we're going to have a smoke alarm.
The one-handed flip, first you knock it and you want to see that you're moving. See that? I've got a good nonstick. And then just back and or forward and back.
Oh my god.
Good. Right here, Bubba. Can you feel that for him?
Yeah.
So you guys have to watch me do this because I couldn't figure out a good way. Hey, open the windows up too, Gus. I couldn't figure out a good way to show it everybody.
The pan spray is coconut oil.
But you can use you can just use butter where you just wipe it in there. You can use anything you want. I think that this for the home cook for sure. We use butter at the restaurant, but I think
normally I try not to buy this kind of container because it's really bad for the environment. But I bought it because I love making waffles, and I was gonna try it out on my waffle maker because the butter was kind of getting everywhere.
And that's what gave me the idea.
You're oiling the pan every crepe.
Yeah. So loose, guys. Ready? Watching. It's loose. You see how there's? You can tell the edge. There's some kind of cooking on the edges, and it's not too liquidy. Ready? One, two, three.
That's so cool.
And then it just gets kissed on this side. So this one's cooking. With just enough time.
Kathy loves our family.
And by the time I've got my crepe in this pan, and I'm swirling around, and this is something, guys, we're going to do savory, but when we're done, I want to talk about, obviously you can see that the kids are excited and engaged in what's going on here. This is a real fun thing to do for breakfast, when it's not ham and cheese. Sweet crepes are great. You can do peanut butter and jelly crepes. You can...
You having a hard time finding a place to stand, Gussie?
No, I want to watch him cook.
I know. But it's hot. It looks like he's kind of going back and forth, so we probably just stand
back here. I'll teach you how to do this. Here. Gus, do you want to teach you how to do this?
I want to flip a pancake.
So someone said they sell a refillable spray. You can add whatever oil you want, get on it. Oh, Misto, yeah, a couple of my friends had those. We should try that.
Who's Misto?
That's the name of a refillable spray bottle.
So I think there might be some mess ups, but we're shooting for around anywhere between 12 and 14 crepes.
Those look so good.
Nice thing about this recipe, the crepes themselves are super fun, and if you're doing it for like a breakfast, more of like a sweeter Nutella, peanut butter and jelly, powdered sugar, jam. Ready? Ready? So, like this, and then you
push it forward.
Do you want to try and flip one, Gus?
No.
Maybe I think you should try.
No, but it's too hot.
You should try.
Grab one with a towel.
Use a towel, and if it lands on the ground, you never know until you try.
And it's okay if you mess up.
I know. I just don't want to get burned.
You're not going to get burned. And even if you do get burned a little bit, like, that's just life. I get burned all the time.
What did you use when you made the 1,000 crepes? Did you use butter?
Yeah. It was for, I had the theme of the James Beard Awards that year was the James Beard Awards were the Oscars of food, so I had to pick my favorite movie, or I had to make a dish that was inspired by a movie. And so I picked Dances with Wolves, and I made crepes out of acorn flour because growing up in Napa, the Native Americans used acorns, and we learned about acorns and cooked with acorns. And then I filled them with buffalo heart mixture. You remember that?
What?
Do you remember that?
No, that's crazy.
You were with me that year. I think that's the year that we won the No Quest.
Maura's mom would use half milk, half pale beer for her crepes.
Half milk, half what?
Half beer.
Oh, yeah. Any liquid really works. See, okay, wow, see how I worked that one out? Okay, so then Gus.